Historic Hollybush in Glassboro, New Jersey, where East meets West. President Johnson, with aides Rusk and McNamara, awaits his first of two summit talks with Soviet Premier Kosygin. Kosygin's arrival marks the first in-person meeting of the two world leaders. Soviet Foreign Minister Gromyko and Ambassador Dobrinin accompany the Russian Premier. During the 5.5-hour discussion, both President and Premier, often with only translators present, exchange views on the Middle East, Vietnam, and arms limitation. A mutual understanding was the initial aim of the talks, conducted in a personally cordial atmosphere. The first conference concludes with expressions of cautious optimism, while a second talk is set for 2 days later. Between talks, tourism. A sightseeing trip to Niagara Falls, where Kosygin, rain-coated, says, "I enjoy the wind and mist in my face." The day also includes stops at hydroelectric power plants on both the U.S. and Canadian sides of the falls. Return to Hollybush, where press and spectators throng the area for a glimpse of the conference principles. The second talk aims at more specific and intensive discussion of world problems. Gate crashers give police a busy afternoon. President and Mrs. Johnson arrive with daughter Linda, while Premier Kosygin also makes it a family affair, bringing daughter Ludmilla. After the conference, both leaders describe the summit talks as useful, agreeing to keep in close personal contact on all global crises. All major issues remain unsettled, despite the cordial diplomacy. In separate statements, Mr. Johnson says the meeting made the world a little less dangerous, but Mr. Kosygin repeats the Soviet hard line on the Mideast and Vietnam.